Ladies and gentlemen, we got an injury update to Jurrien Timber, as you guys already know. We have an update on Kieran Tierney potentially leaving the club. Zinchenko, he's getting there, but he's our other left back. Tomiyasu can also play left back. Jakub Kaber can also play left back. Do we have a left back issue now that Jurrien Timber is out and Kieran Tierney is still potentially going to be leaving? Would you guys want to keep Kieran Tierney? Let me know. And also, certain Flo Balogun, there's a report that a £50 million bid, or I think actually it might be €50 million bid, might be coming in from Monaco, and the club might be looking to accept it. Is it unfair that we're not giving Balogun a chance before selling him this transfer window? Let me know what you guys think about that. And finally, Cucurella to Arsenal? What's going on? Kudus is headed to West Ham. The whole Caicedo Latvia drama is hilarious watching from distance, but wow. Let me give you guys a quick little update. Egal Talks Football, love for the love people. Hopefully hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and let's get this show started. I know it's not another live stream, it's another upload, but hopefully you still enjoy this content. And let me know what you guys think in the comment section.
Here we go.
Yes, people, let's get started. First things first, how's everyone doing today? Hopefully everybody's doing well on this wonderful Monday. The last game of the first week of the Premier League is going to be happening today versus Manchester United. So, of course, as always, I'm just going to give you guys a quick prediction. I think Man United is going to win 3-1. But now let's get into the actual games. Why am I saying the games? The predictions and all that other stuff, we leave that for our vibes for the six. But let's get into the big news. The big news is all the stuff happened around Jurrien Timber and everything around that. So let's get into it right about here. So first, we got some news on Kieran Tierney. The news on Kieran Tierney is that Newcastle are looking to sign the left back on loan before both Arsenal and Chelsea. Cucurella's are, they're interested in both. Now, there has been rumors that Arsenal are also interested in Cucurella, but I just don't think that makes sense. Now, in the other side of things, you have that both deals will either be obligations or options to buy. I don't think we're going to loan him out, but there is also more news on this because it's reported that he's edging closer and closer to an exit, as the Chronicle over in Newcastle say that the Scotsman has never gone away this summer, and it's difficult for Newcastle, but they're going to try their best. Arsenal demanding $30 million for the 26-year-old. Newcastle, of course, don't want to pay that much money for him. Arsenal are willing to do a part only at a price that is in a strong position for the player, with they have 3 years left. So yeah, Arsenal do have a strong position for the player since there is 2 years left. We've done business before with Joe Willock. So of course, this is something that is possible to do. But the main point is that Kieran Tierney is closer to a move away from the Arsenal. And I seen a different article earlier today, but let me just try to find that. So what I was reading earlier today, they were basically talking about Kieran Tierney potentially going on loan to Newcastle. Newcastle are interested in him. Arsenal are valuing between 30 to 25 million. And the interest still remain. We still remain interested, but we're going to have to wait and see how things progress from there. Now, let me just pull this up for you guys before we go any further. And let me just pull this up for you guys. So yeah, so here is one of the reports. Newcastle remain interested in signing. Contact throughout the summer between both parties involved. Maggie's would agree a loan with an obligation to buy for Arsenal to sanction his departure. I don't think it's a good thing. It doesn't make sense. Let me know what you guys think. Would it be a good thing to let Kieran Tierney leave, especially if we are on the eve of finding out if Timber is going to be injured for a long time period or not? Does it really make sense for us to be letting him leave on a loan to a Premier League club that could potentially be rivaling us in a year or two's time? It just doesn't make sense to loan him out. Yeah, I think if we were to sell him, it would make more sense for both parties for it to be a permanent deal, a £25 million deal maybe. But I do value Kieran Tierney more than the valued 25 million that at this moment in time. So yeah, Here's another report. Fresh Newcastle contact with Kieran Tierney as a departure. And then you have more news here. Reportedly keen to leave this summer. Arsenal value Kieran Tierney at 25 million. They paid around a similar price for him from Celtic, and they're inquiring to get him on loan, on a loan deal. Okay, so we're gonna have to wait and see how that progresses and how that is going to go on from here. Now, moving on to the other news. I don't know if you guys have heard, but there is some sad news about Timber's status and his injury status, because reportedly we knew that Timber getting injured the other day was not good from the fact that he was holding his knee. It was a non-contact injury and everything else. But there is initial scans that have come back, and Arsenal are worried that it could be bad. Yes, it could be bad. Reported after the initial scans, Arsenal feared that Jurrien Timber has suffered a serious knee injury, and further assessments could be required in the coming days over the possible danger of a meniscus tear. Now, this could be an injury where he's out for months, ladies and gentlemen. He could be gone for months. He's undergoing various tests since it's happened. There's no confirmation yet, but yes, it's understood that major concerns over Jurrien Timber suffering a knee ligament injury and will keep him sidelined for months rather than just weeks. I'm gutted for the guy. He literally just joined us, and since he's been playing with us in preseason, he's looked really good. We haven't really gotten to see him test himself against the big boys, but against Man City, he looked good. Against some of the other guys that we played this preseason, he looked good. And that first half, when he was on the pitch, he looked really good. And this is a player who could fill in at right back, left back, center back. And now injuries are a pain. And just when we thought we were all set for the new season, we now find ourselves in a situation again where we might be dependent on the guys like Rob Holding. It's just a shame. Are we going to sign somebody else before the window ends? I don't really think so. What are we going to do? Mikel Arteta is going to have to figure it out. How long is he going to be out for? Still no confirmation. I'm hopeful that we get an actual confirmation. And once we do get a confirmation, that maybe it's some better news. But at this moment in time, the Jurrien Timber stuff is very sad. Let me know what you guys think. What should Arsenal do with the whole Jurrien Timber situation? And what do you guys think will happen? We got the local Arsenal doctor on Twitter gave his analysis on what he thinks might be going on. A few things to add. ACL, full rupture, are relatively clear via hand test. And then he said MRI explaining Militao likely Mings. Those injuries were confirmed quickly. Meniscus injuries are largely variants related to the ligament also involved. So it could be something that it's difficult to see, but we're not doctors. I can't really denounce too much of what he's even saying, but we're going to find out with more tests how bad the injury is. And all we can say is we wish Jurrien Timber the best. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Please do spam some love to my guy, Jurrien Timber. Show him some love. Hopefully we can send him some good wishes, and hopefully he can get well soon, because this is very sad that we're going to have a player of such importance getting injured this close to the window ending. And I don't think we're going to have enough time to get a replacement in. That's just my honest truth at this moment in time. But let's get into the next thing. We got to talk about Balogun. If you guys don't know, the Secret Scout reported that Balogun has... There's information that from the Secret Scout that reports that Balogun, that Monaco are in pole position to sign Balogun from Arsenal. West Ham are also interested. Inter are keen but unable to pay the demanded fee. So reported that Monaco are now getting ready for £50 million bid for Balogun. Let's see what happens. At this moment in time, it's just speculation, but they're speculating that a £50 million bid for Balogun is being prepared at this moment in time. And if that is true, that is massive. Balogun could be potentially joining Arsenal I mean, leaving Arsenal to Monaco for around £50 million. Now, Arsenal did reject Monaco's original offer of £40 million. And here's a better breakdown of what is actually happening. So Monaco are in negotiations with Arsenal over the 21-year-old Flo Balogun. La Liga club offered $40 million for the U.S. international, which was rejected by Arsenal. Arsenal want $50 million, and Inter left the race. Tottenham are following, but I don't think we're going to sell to Tottenham. And talks are ongoing. So just to let you guys know, it's unfortunate that Balogun is not going to be given an opportunity to actually prove himself at Arsenal before he's being sold. But it almost seems clear that the club are looking to sell him, and he's going to most likely be moved on. So because he hasn't been used in preseason and he hasn't been used at the beginning of the season, even with Gabriel Jesus' injury, I do think Balogun will not be given an opportunity to play at Arsenal or to prove himself. And do you think that's unfair or fair? Let me know in the comment section. Personally, for me, I think Mikel Arteta knows what he's doing, and there might be some sort of agreement or something in place where the player can go on and do what he needs to do. £50 million seems like a really good deal for Arsenal. And if we can get the £50 million from Monaco, that could be money that could be used elsewhere in the future or right now, this transfer window, if something, a good opportunity comes up. So we're going to have to wait and see. Personally, for me, I'm not picking Eddie over Balogun, but that seems to be what the club are doing. And the fact that Tottenham are following this one, he's not going to Tottenham. Let's just keep it up real. He's not going to Tottenham. Balogun, if he's going to go anywhere, he's going to probably go to France. It's not a Premier League club. We don't have to worry about him. And if we sell him on a permanent, maybe we'll get a sell-on clause or a buyback clause, whatever it is. But I'm happy with that deal. That's just me. I'm happy with that deal. I'll take that deal all day long. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section, and we keep it moving. In other news, David Raya deal is going to happen soon. So we're going to have to wait and see when that David Raya deal is going to get done, because it no real big information on the David Raya deal in a while now. If I'm not mistaken, last Thursday, everything was sorted. So we're just waiting to see when that will be confirmed. Arsenal option to buy David Raya will turn into an obligation if certain criteria are met. So at this moment in time, it does look like that is going to happen. So there's not much more to be said on the David Raya stuff. And yeah, we're just waiting for a here you go from David Raya and an official announcement from the club on the whole David Raya stuff. I don't think there's anything's going to come from that anytime soon. So we're just going to have to wait and see when things escalate from there. Now, moving on to something else that I just wanted to touch on quickly. I don't know if you guys know, but Mohamed Kudus is going to potentially move to a Premier League club, but it's not Brighton. He might be going to West Ham. Yes, he seems like he wants to go to the London club, West Ham. West Ham are in a situation where they might be selling Lucas Paqueta. Mohamed Kudus could be going for as low as £38 million to West Ham. West Ham have open talks, and he seems like he's more open to the move to go to West Ham over Brighton. Now, I was speaking to my boy Libs about this, and I think it's actually a smart move for him going to the London club. I even tweeted it out. Yeah, I did tweet it out. Good move going to London club. They just won the Conference League. He could be the main man over there. And at Arsenal, he'd really be a bit part player. Sometimes for the player, it's not only about quality of life, it's also the place where they could potentially be utilized the most. I don't think Arsenal or Chelsea are seriously in for Mohamed Kudus. It just seems like we're linked to him, but we're not serious about this transfer. But for now, let me know what you guys think. Do you guys think Arsenal are going to get another signing through the door before the window ends? Because at this moment in time, you never know with Arsenal. If an opportunity arises, the opportunity arises. But it does look like Balogun's going to go. It does look like Kieran Tierney might be going. And is it a mistake to sell either or both of them? Let me know. And finally, just hopes and prayers to Jurrien Timber. Hopefully the injury is not as bad as it is, because I'm gutted for him. I'm absolutely devastated. But yeah, you guys have yourselves a wonderful day. I'm out of here. Hopefully you enjoy the stream, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Love for the love, people. Remember, we're going to be back tomorrow with a live stream with the panel talking about Arsenal at around 8 o'clock, hopefully. But peace.